Okay, this way looks good. I think the game could stand to be a little bit louder.
Are you ready, true believers? Capcom and Marvel have joined forces once again to bring you It's Marvel Super Heroes vs. Street Fighter! Look, spectacular action! Don't miss out on the enjoyment of a lifetime! Behold, amazing fantasy! Don't miss the most amazing tag team fighting game ever! Are you ready for a new challenger? History! Experience Marvel Super Heroes vs.
Okay, yeah, that's exactly what I was talking about. The Japanese version has an additional character not seen in any other version called Nori Marvel. He has not appeared in any other game, excuse me, for that matter as well. So yeah, that's why I'm going to be playing the Japanese version instead of the English version for this game only. Let's get started with the game.
To the adventure! Welcome to the adventure! Choose your alter ego!
Let's see, who haven't we seen before? Oh, I guess Dan, but we also haven't seen... Yeah, I'm not gonna play as Dan. I would say that I played this game about as much. No, actually, I played this a little bit more than X-Men vs. Street Fighter. I like this game more because of the larger variety of characters to play as. But this is basically the exact same game as X-Men vs. Street Fighter. It just with a different roster. It has all the same stages and same sprites and everything. And even the final boss is the same. Like you still fight Apocalypse at the end of this game, just like in X-Men vs. Street Fighter. But yeah, they basically just recycled everything. And change the roster a bit for this game. No, no. Oh, God. I wanted to finish him off with Nori Maru, but his health got too low for you to be comfortable with. And yeah, I'm definitely not gonna even try to read that. Hulk. This game might not have Juggernaut, but Hulk can be just as much of a pain in the ass to fight against. Oh God. Good. We got him out of the way. No! Man!
Final Atomic Buster!
like one of the worst teams you can go up against. I'm pretty sure I can pick different characters and it'll keep my progress. Okay, so I definitely wanna. Definitely want to take care of Zangief first. This would become so much easier if I could just get rid of him. But the fact that Hulk wasn't included in the team this time actually worries me, because that means that I can face him later on now, and he'll be a much bigger problem if I fight him later than now. At least I switched out the characters in time. Gotta take that selfie. That background is a bit different in this version as well, since there's more than just X-Men now. If time ran out anyway, but I want to keep Norimaru, but I I keep doing these accidental grabs. like that. That time he grabbed me. I really wish that would have finished him off. Ugh. Okay, good. Switch there, whatever. God. One now, because I'm up against the Hulk. Really would have preferred fighting him earlier on. Damage to you very quickly. Wow, okay. Yet again. Aw. And I suppose they added a pre-battle dialogue for the apocalypse fight as well. Kind of wish Norimaru was included in other languages just so I could see what he has to say. Guess I could always just look up a translation though. Oh, didn't mean to switch. Whatever. I'll just keep using him for the rest of the fight. Wow. Actually managed to beat him without losing a character. Oh, that's right. You fight against Mecha Akuma in After Apocalypse in this game. Oh boy. Thank you. Than anything else you can absolutely do in this game. Sure. Let's give Spider-Man a try. Just pick who I think I can actually win with.
Choose your Spider-Man!
Wow. There's a good reason why that's just a one-on-one fight. Nice fight. And it just says that in English. Oh, I wish I could read this. Oh well, I could always just look it up if I want to know what it says. Why does it look like they're in outer space, though? Okay, so I would say this game is harder than it's, so from the games that I've played right now, these Marvel vs. Capcom fighting games, Children of the Atom, definitely the hardest one of them all, with Marvel Super Heroes below that, and I would place this game in between Marvel Super Heroes and X-Men vs. Street Fighter, which is the easiest one so far. The next one is Marvel vs. Capcom, but we still got some other Marvel games to get to before we play that one. So, don't really know what else to say. I think this one is the best one of them all so far, because it has the largest roster and thus the largest selection of characters to choose from. Plus, I also think that the music is better, is the best of them all so far as well, you know. So yeah, definitely the best one of the series so far, but obviously not the best one in the entire series, you know, because Marvel 2 and 3 exists.